that better people from our this part of the world also become IAS officers. So that other states, South Indian, East Indian, they were grabbing the opportunity. He is going out of the way to help out the dozen part of India. Punjabi, Haryanvi, Himachali, all these people come here and get first-class education and do very good work here. I wish all the success for future people and thank him genuinely, because I am deeply indebted to him in looking after me as an old man, grandchildren of mine. I was telling him, my grandson who is doing LLB in Punjab University, I told him, you finish your LLB and I will put you in this piece. Already told to him in advance. And I said, you will qualify to do both of that. Now, here to bring it today, I would like to wish the Institute all the success. Thank you each one of you for taking the trouble of coming here. It's indeed a pleasure to welcome all of you, particularly the chief guest who has come a little longer distance than I have come, but very welcome to him. We have got another gentleman who has been ambassador of India to our side. He is also present. SSP Saab, Ambassador Saab, both of them are present. Excellent people. And I wish a very good manner of this, about this institute. I have explained to you briefly. And I wish that all of you go and tell youngsters, if you want to go IAS, PCS, there is an institute to teach it. Thank you.
Saying that my best wishes to all the future bureaucrats, and I wish you have a good stint in the bureaucracy for the next 30 to 35 years you have, depending on your age at which you enter in the service. It is a very good institute. My wife has been here, she is in railway service, so she was praising sir a lot. and I wish she was here also, sir, today. More than that, I would just say a few words of advice for you. Whichever service you get in, you will have ample chance to serve the country. If you want to give your exam again, then also you have ample opportunities to do that. But right now, what I feel is, in my 7 years of service, what I have seen is that people somehow they start getting discontented with the service. All said and done, this exam continues to be the best still, and for a long time to come. I have my cousins who are graduated from IIT Delhi, then IIM Ahmedabad in my family, and then there are many bureaucrats also. After a few years of service, if we compare our careers, mostly bureaucrats, they tend to do much better than their counterparts in the business field. Some of them may do exceptionally well, they may outshine you, but in generally, it is a very good field. So please give your best, and I congratulate all the parents and family members who are here, all the well-wishers, for sparing their time and coming here, and for their patience in getting their wards and children through the exam. Thank you, sir.
Anil Kumar, director of the institute, guest of honor, senior student in Chandigarh, members of the faculty, selectees for the civil service exam, media, guests. I see some senior IPS officers from batches like 64 and other batches. Very nice to see you, sir, here. I belong to the Indian Foreign Service of 1980 batch. I got an opportunity a couple of times to come to the institute to do some mock interviews over there. I was impressed by the atmosphere there. I was impressed by the interviews also, and some of, I can see some cases were selected. I think some of those interviews will be conducted. Being from the Foreign Service, I think none of you is going to Foreign Service. Are you going to Foreign Service?
I might.
Very good. Very good. Congratulations. And congratulations to everybody, even not only the family is going to Foreign Service. Last year somebody asked me, that my daughter is going for Foreign Service, but some people are telling that this is not a good service. Could somebody guide her, tell her, you are going to join a great service if you're going for Foreign Service. Actually, whatever service you're going to join under this examination, you are going to join the top service of the country in that particular field. Be it IAS, be it IPS, be it any of the central services. It's the top service in that particular specialized field. And you get an opportunity at a young age to make a great contribution to improvement. The guest of honor mentioned that some of the challenges which are emerging for the civil service now, actually, those challenges are to be accepted as challenges and opportunities to make these together. This is how the service will evolve. I was in Afghan, in Sudan in 2004 when the parliamentary elections were being held. MPs of the Lok Sabha, I think 2-3 months before the elections are held, an American diplomat asked me at a party, you don't have a government for 3 months, how do you run the country? I told him we run the country much better when we don't have the government. That is because of the civil service we have. So I served 12 years in Africa. I retired as a high commissioner in Zambia. I was there for 5 years. What I see in those countries is they don't have a good civil service. Governance deficit is due to the fact they don't have a proper organized, neutral foreign service, which we have. So you, as a civil servant, contribute a lot to the governance of this country. India is a very complex country to work. It is the most complex federal polity in the world. The UN civil servants have a great role to play when you serve whichever service you belong to. So I would like to congratulate you for having been selected for this, any of these services. And you have a long life ahead, you have a long career ahead. I would like it that take your training seriously when you go to a CV, when you go to your specialized institutes, because this is an opportunity to learn from the very beginning. And don't let cynicism come into your mind. A lot is happening, a lot will continue to happen, as the complexities of countries are so great. All kind of forces interplay into our federal polity from everywhere. You really are the friends team of the Indian administration. So you need to protect yourself and also understand those forces, how they impinge upon you, how they impinge on the national interest. So I give you my good wishes. Even during the service, still honesty remains the best policy. So I think take your training seriously, take your job seriously, and you have a great job to do. You have a great contribution to make to the country. And the media which has come here, I like to thank them for coming. I like to thank the guests for coming. I like the institute who have played a role in your selection, played a great role. I would like the senior secretaries for having come over. That was function to encourage the youngsters here. And I like to thank you very much. Have a good day.
Thank you very much. Let's join for the cup of tea. If anyone wants to have any questions for media, they can ask questions or we can have a photograph.
Thank you. Chandigarh is being articulated.
ये एक बच्चों का सेना में सजा